Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Welcome to Journeys of Hope. This weekend, we have our guest for this weekend, one of my close friends in ABS. Worked with him a lot, Direk Alco Guerrero. Direk, welcome. Welcome to Journeys.
Hi. Good afternoon, Faj. Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon. And alam mo, Direk, ano, eh, diba? I've been talking to people, our artists, the managers, even I talk to, and you know, just asking them to share their journey, given that many changes in the entertainment industry, no. So first time namin magkakaroon ng guest na director talking about this topic, ano, the changes in the entertainment industry. So maybe you can talk about your journey, no? With all the shifts going on. No?
My journey personally, Pats.
Yeah.
Medyo mahaba yan.
As a director, yeah.
Well, I mean, this has always been on my mind. And this has always been something I've said na I'm thankful for. Kumbaga sa mga sinasabi ng mga bata ngayon, hashtag blessed. Kasi yung nanay ko, executive producer, noon-noon pa, noong 70s pa, naging producer siya ni Vilma. So it was easy for me to enter the world kasi na-expose ako na maaga. It was easy for me to identify who I wanted to be, and that's something that's so medyo rare yan sa mga bata ngayon kasi ano, diba, kids, they tend to try something, it was very easy for me to find my place in things and to hone my talent. But at the same time, double-edged sword din siya because my mom's name loomed over me.
Yeah, definitely, no? I mean, maybe just for people to know, aside from being the producer for Vilma and all that, the last few years, she would be the one behind the ABS-CBN Christmas specials and basta special events ng ABS. It was Chito was always in charge. No, punong abala, ka nga, the producer.
Yeah, si Ma'am Chit Guerrero. So,
Ma'am Chit Guerrero, yes.
So that was always there. But I took it later on. When I was beginning to understand what it meant, no? I'm sure you can feel this from your fans, no? Mas na challenge ako sa kanya. Parang how do I do that name justice? How do I do that name a service? You know, I mean, the mothers will always be proud of their sons, whatever they do. But
good or bad.
I wanted more.
Yeah,
and my. Personally, my journey has not been about, of course, importante yung marami kang trabaho, marami kang project. Pero like now, in the later years, importante kung ano yung ginagawa mo. Hindi kung ilan.
Not so much yung volume ng work, but the quality. No?
Oo. You know, when you enter the business, there will be so many opportunities. Left and right, and opportunities within opportunities.
Yeah.
But, you know naman, Pat, I'm a very big fan of music. And I've often told this to people who have sought my advice. I said, if you cannot hear music where you are, get out. You're in trouble. Kasi yun yung sign ko na, ano, na okay to. You're able to hear music in your head. You're able to allow yourself to be inspired. If it's all noise, you're in trouble.
Yeah, but you've maintained a certain love for your craft, but also certain integrity. As you said, it's not the number of projects you really have, but the projects that you believe in, no? And hindi lang basta quality, basta it's also the projects that you believe in, ano?
Yes, and there's a certain, ako, Pads, I mean, I'm no saint, I'm quite the rebel, but I wanted to find ways to channel that rebellion. And sometimes channeling a rebellion is not destroying a system or going against. Sometimes it's finding your ways around the system. Like, for example, tayo, we work on a lot of projects na hindi ganong kalaki yung funding, hindi ganong kalaki yung resources. So you get creative around it.
Yeah.
You find a way to still achieve what you want to achieve. And that, in a way, is rebellion. Diba? Kasi...
Yeah.
Parang nakaisa ka eh. Naitayo mo siya ng ganto-ganto lang eh. Diba?
Kaya nga, you back the system, diba? So,
yeah. So, that is the challenge for me. I am more likely to celebrate when you get a gang of guys and you pull something off than when you have everyone and you pull something off.
Yeah.
Mas na-excite ako sa kulang kayo pero na-deliver mo.
Yeah. No, without mentioning the details of the project, we had a project a year ago, 1 year ago na pala yun.
Yeah, 1 year ago, yes.
Yeah,
so
you know, we had, siguro if I can share, just jump in and throw in your own 2 cents worth. No?
Yeah.
Number one, wala kaming budget. Asa lang kung papasok na donations. It was a fundraiser for different youth groups. Number one, wala kaming budget. Number two, puro pakiusap, di ba? And, you know, we wanted to pay, but we don't have that much money to pay. So, pakiusap, tawad-tawad here and there, di ba? And, ano, but sabi nga natin, di ba? Natawid natin, di ba? And, and people who did not know what was happening behind the scenes would never have suspected what we went through, no? Up to the day of the event, hindi natin alam, di ba, Direk? Kung may pambabayad tayo sa, well, hindi natin alam kung may pambabayad tayo sa equipment. Hindi natin alam kung may pambabayad tayo sa, kasi ayaw na, and remember, maybe this is also one thing I want to emphasize. You know, COVID, and, you know, people are looking for a job, di ba? Hindi naman to nung araw na, alam mo naman, di ba, no, direct before COVID and everything, pag nakiusap tayo, people are happy to do it for free, no? Pag alam nila yung,
right.
Yung cost is naman napaka worthwhile, pero ito ayaw mong gawin yon kasi alam mo mga tao is also struggling from COVID, di ba? Pero yung project
right.
natin down the wire, eh kaya nila down the wire, di ba? But and correct me if I'm wrong, ah, you know, nakakapagod, di naman nakaka-tense, but you know, I never felt stressed by it. Parang alam ko ganyan talaga, di ba? And but still, no, parang we natawid natin, di ba? And again, no, in great part, thank you for your leadership, and ang dami mong pinakausapan na talents to come and play at a practically minimal cost, di ba? Ayaw naman natin, sabi ko, di ba, ayaw natin ng TY kasi alam natin kailangan din ng mga tao, di ba? So is that the way you generally work? I mean, pag naniwala ka sa isang project.
Ako kasi fans. I mean, if I were to be honest about it, I can safely say that I, in my opinion, I am not the best director. If you want to rank things best, what's but you know, when you are forced to take a hard look at the competition, when you're forced to identify your strengths, diba? And your weaknesses also.
Yeah.
One strength I identified is sa akin is I can be quite infectious when I am enthused, when I am excited about something.
A project,
yes. When I maintain a certain positivity about something. And I like, you know, I'm quite self-aware, so I like myself when I am like that. I like the effects I have on people when I am like that. So, and this is funny, Fad, because I'm an introvert. Pangkisa ako eh. So that is the job for me. As much as the actual directing, the job for me is to make sure everyone in my team feels a certain drive to achieve and contribute, and that's what I like.
Yeah.
So ever since, I have always made it a point to be cordial, to always hindi ako yung director na nagdidikta.
Oh, correct. Yeah, yeah.
Plus, I mean, without naming names, no, fans, in this industry, marami ng director na namatay, nagkasakit, because they succumb to the pressure. They change. They allow it to change them. Mm-hmm. Ayoko mangyari sa akin yun.
Okay.
Maraming director na nagka-atake sa puso. I've seen them.
Kasi ako mo yung project, di ba? I mean, di ba? In fact, but, I remember when I would talk to people, you know, with some proposals and all that, lagi nila sinasabi, oh, ito yung kwento, ito yung project, but at the end of the day, mahalaga yung vision ng director for the project. Yes. And Alex, ano, just a question. I never really ask you this question, no? Kasi, di ba, you're really known now more for events, di ba? Yung mga shows, mga specials. But have you ever tried to direct mga teleserye or mga narratives, no? For example, an episode in maalala mo kaya an episode in basta ano yung tawag doon, ipaglaban mo, or really you found ever since you wanted the shows, the events, type of thing?
Ever since kasi I was a big fan of concerts. Talaga ang hilig ko. So, okay. Mas doon ako napunta in terms of directing a narrative. I cannot say I would want to do it, nor would I not want to do it. I guess it's a matter of the right project and circumstances.
Yeah.
But I am a big fan of our storytellers, lalo na I've made a lot of friends over the pandemic.
Yeah.
Direk Richard Somes, Direk Eric Mati, these are people who I've gotten close to. Siguro sa ngayon, Pats, masasabi ko medyo, hindi naman sa takot, pero parang feeling ko mas maraming mas magaling. Parang, ang sa akin lang is how do I serve the craft? Marami namang ways yan.
Yeah.
Marami namang ways.
Yeah.
And ako, like for example, tayo, we're embarking on a new project. I mean, these are spaces that I'm very happy in, because there are spaces that, you know me, Fads, when we talk about an idea, sometimes it will go from 0 to 60 very fast, because I can see from a concept standpoint where we can go and what we can do with it. And
ang tawag dyan, malikot ang isip.
Malikot ang utak ako. And lalo na when it comes to, you know, somehow instilling positivity.
Pag mga
true
ano,
positivity.
Direct, mga purpose or mission driven projects, di ba? Yun yung
Oo. I like the idea that you are touching someone, that you are empowering someone, and I'm not just saying that for the sake of saying it. It really makes a difference.
Correct.
It really, because at the end of the day, you know, when no one is around, and you start thinking, ano ba nagawa ko sa buhay ko to?
Yeah.
Doon mo maiisip, nagawa ko to. Okay. Sige, gawin mo pa. Ulitin mo pa. Diba?
Correct.
Dagdagan mo pa. Yun eh.
Yeah, but direct question, no? Kasi in a teleserye or a narrative, ano, it's very clear, diba? You work with the story, no? You work with the story.
Yes.
But also my experience in my projects with you, and now we're coming up with probably one of the biggest projects we're gonna work on now, no? Hindi ba direct meron din kahit sabihin mong we're mounting an event, we're mounting a show, you're mounting a concert, but especially we're mounting an event, di ba mahalaga rin yung ano ba yung kwentong gusto natin paabot? Even though it's
mahalaga.
How does that translate, di ba? For example, go ahead.
Everything you do in terms of media, whether it's 5 minutes or an hour, has to have an effect. It has to impart something in anyone who is going to witness it, whether that's a movie or a concert or even just a 5-minute song. Ano yung gusto mong emotion, diba? Like for example, Pat, when we did that fundraiser for the youth, diba? We wanted a feeling of enabling the youth to feel that they could actually affect things.
Yes,
that's what
yes.
we wanted.
Yeah.
That they were part, that they, yes, they were individual, but also they were part of a bigger picture. They were a dynamic, moving force. So that's what we wanted. So it sometimes it's not a story. Sometimes it's a repetitive theme that you continuously drive up within a song, within a series of numbers or fields or what.
Yeah.
Yun po.
Okay.
Yeah.
So when you direct something like that, no, what's the process? What's the process that you go through? No? That's one question that I have. And the second question I want to ask after you discuss this is how has directing how has the changes in technology, like now multi-platform tayo, di ba? Especially ABS, we've lost our PTV franchise,
yeah.
Sir, and but amazing how we're expanding into other platforms. I was
digital.
We're one of the biggest, I believe, in YouTube, ano? Worldwide.
Yes, we are.
We're one of the biggest. Ilan na tayo? 24 million ba? Ilan na ba?
I think 44 million.
44 million. Oh, yeah. Anyway, how do you, what's the process of your mounting a project? And then what is the shift that happened, no, given the different platforms now available?
Ako personally, my process always begins with music. Like when we had a project, when you had given me the brief for this current project, nakinig ako ng Bob Marley.
Yeah.
Because Bob Marley is such a powerful revolutionary artist.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes music speaks in ways that we cannot even comprehend. And it becomes ideas, it becomes certain, you know, the ideas have smaller ideas, and then I meet with the producer and, can we do this? Can we do that? Can we tap this? It all happens very, very fast. And then, para siyang ano, Padre, para siyang nag-painting ka, winisik-wisik mo lahat. Tapos, pag tatapos ka na, teka, kulang pa ng ganito.
In other words,
para siyang
it takes a life of its own.
Yes, it does.
Eventually,
it does.
No?
And it's very, again, this is why I maintain a spirit of positivity, because that cannot happen if lahat kayo know people. That cannot happen.
Yeah.
Yung sa simula pa lang, ay, hindi kaya to. Ay, hindi kaya to. Huwag ganun. Alam, lahat yan may challenges.
Okay.
What you need are people who will tell you, kaya natin to kung ganito. Kaya natin to kapag ganito.
Okay.
Not people who will flat out say no. Ako, I don't like that. Hindi ko kasundo yung taong ganun.
We'll never
pero
make it.
Yun,
we'll never make
oo,
it.
Kasi pag ganun, aabot ka kagad sa, ba't pa natin ginagawa to?
Yeah. So you always put in a positive outlook in your process.
Yes.
Uh-oh.
Yes, because the work is hard. I'm not saying it's easy. It's very hard. So, ba't pa natin pahirapan yung sarili natin? Mahirap na yung trabaho. Padaliin natin. Kasi, di ba, parang relationship lang yan, Pads. Kung in love kayo sa ginagawa o in love ka sa partner mo, hindi ba madali lahat? Ganun din yung trabaho.
Yeah.
Kung hindi ka in love dyan, mahirap lahat. Kung pakiusapan ka ng partner mo tapos hindi ka na in love, parang pagod na pagod ka nga, di ba? Pero kung in love ka, ikaw pa magsasabi, hindi, gawin ko yan. Di ba?
Yeah.
So really, it's...
That's interesting. Yeah. I mean, it's a very nice analogy, no? Na pag mahal mo yung tao, mahal mo yung ginagawa mo. Iba, because I think that drives home the point, ano? the
Yeah,
shift
yeah.
in ano siya, shift in perspective. Kasi when you think about it, the demand of the job did not
It's
change,
hard.
diba?
Yes.
But the way you look at it shifted, no? And it makes it not just bearable but maybe even enjoyable, no? So
Enjoyable, unforgettable,
yeah. You know, Derek, ano,
life-changing at
no?
times.
Before we go now to be, before we go to my second question about given the technology and the shift of platforms, before I go to that, you know, as I mentioned, I don't know, earlier, always, you know, always when I have a when I discuss a project, always people would say, okay, that's a project, this is the concept, but in the end, what is the vision of the director? And I know people choose the director based on the vision that he or she would pitch, you know. So what does that mean? What does that mean, that that the project's success or mounting, I don't know what to call it, would depend on the vision of the director?
Well, I no, I think vision is a collective thing, because anything we do in terms of media is a collective. But
okay.
When you, siguro when you say vision, like particularly with what we do, it's how to get the collective drive of everyone and express it in the most effective ways. That's where a director comes in. Like,
yeah.
For example, how to interpret a desire by a collective. Like, for example, tayo, you came to me with, okay, I have this group, they want to do this. How do we achieve it? The
Yeah.
director is the one who concretizes it.
Okay.
Pads, gawa tayo ng one, like what I told you, pads, we can do a 1 hour show, we can have this outside, that inside, di ba?
Yes, yes.
These are, kumbaga sa ano, if I were to if I were to have an analogy for it, it's like all of you guys, 50 guys, saying we want to go very fast, and the director says, "Okay, let's take a plane."
That's a nice, simple analogy. No? So. Okay.
Kasi maraming kliyente, hindi may gusto silang mangyari. They want to grow their business. They want awareness for their drive. Hindi nila ma-zero in kung paano.
In execution. Execution.
Pwedeng maraming idea yan. Baka pwedeng ganito, ganito, ganito. Or ganito, ganito, ganito. Yung director yung magsasabi, hindi, sakay tayo sa aeroplano.
Yeah, good, very good analogy. So how, ano, Derek, how has the platforms, the technology, how is it affected? For example, I remember that was the height of the pandemic. I watched a concert actually, online, yung concert ng BGYO.
Right.
I watched them online. No? So, but how has it affected the industry, of course, and especially your field, so to speak, no, in the industry? How is it the platforms and the different changes going on?
Well, actually the changes even before the pandemic, but malaki na.
Yeah.
So I used to be part of One Music, and when my experience when we were doing One Music is, yes, people still like going to their concert, participating and all that. Pero there's so many layers to that. Like, number one, traditional media that entails more than five people, us, the network, the bigger network. I'm not saying na kawawa naman yung Pilipinas, pero malayo na yung naabot ng ibang bansa. Like, if we look at the output of, let's say, Korea.
Korea, diba? Amazing, yeah.
Yeah, because the government is behind them. If you look at the output of all these Netflix series na sobrang ganda, na parang, you know, pag tayo, I'm sure you can identify, pag nanood tayo ng series before, sitcom lang yan, diba?
Yeah.
Sitcom. But now, if you watch the series, I mean, from from that series before yung 24, para ka nanonood ng pelikula.
Yeah,
kasi
yeah.
ganong ganong kaganda yon. And I don't know if you've seen The Crown.
Yeah, I've seen. I like the older seasons more than the present.
Yeah, the older season. But these are series na the way they're captured, the way they're mounted, it's practically like it's movies,
yes,
small movies,
correct.
Diba?
Yeah.
So I mean, we are trying, but the economic implications of having to mount something like that is just not something that I think any network is prepared for.
Yeah.
Diba? There is that. That is the dilemma of big media or traditional media. And that's also because we are losing, or not necessarily losing, but how's a better way to say it? Mas nag-gain ground ngayon yung individual creator. People on TikTok, YouTube creators. These people have become so powerful that they are actually able to influence cultural shifts just by having a team of two or three, or even kahit sila lang.
Yeah.
Like if you guys want to study YouTube, you might want to study this user called Mr. Beast. Yun, grabe. He has 140 million subscribers.
Wow.
And he figured out a way to make YouTube he figured out a way to make his earnings in YouTube become even bigger. Grabe si Mr. Beast, fans. Ang mga ginagawa niyang content, halimbawa, mag-Uber driver ka for a day. Tapos, alba, ako si Mr. B, sinundo kita. Pinansundo ko sa'yo, Tesla. Diba? Hinatid kita. Pagkahatid ko sa'yo, sa'yo na yung Tesla. Ganun ka, grabe. Namimigay ng...
But that's how big he earns.
Yes, but see, when he puts that video out, he gets 100 million views.
Wow.
Or 60 million views. So, yung pambili niya ng Tesla ay bawi na.
Bawing bawi, yeah.
Diba?
Yeah.
But he has the business sense to do that.
Yeah.
Diba?
Yeah.
And ano na siya? Evergreen na siya. Now, I'm not saying this as... it takes a certain mindset to be able to master the language and the business side of things.
Yeah.
I think that's where the shift really happened, because creators now have, the really good creators have a really good business sense about things. Dati kasi pag artist lang, mad genius by temper, whatever. I mean, not to be stereotypical, but di ba?
Yeah.
Ngayon ang creator is also a very shrewd businessman. Diba?
Kailangan, ano? It's necessary.
Kailangan.
Yeah. So, Direk, any final words, let's say, to young, aspiring people who want to go into media, not necessarily directing, but wants to become part of this industry?
Siguro, on a final note, I would say that it's wide open. You will learn the rules, but the whatever rules you learn, i-master mo, knowing that one day you will be powerful enough to break them. But when I say break them, I'm not saying destroy them.
I mean to break them positively, no?
Yes.
Up the ante, so to speak, no?
Yes.
So,
yes.
Direk, maraming salamat. Yes. Thank you for your time. I know you've also been very busy, but maraming salamat. I look forward to our project. And I think soon people will know what this project we're talking about. So, maraming salamat, Direk. And have a good day.
Maraming salamat.
Thank you.
Salamat. All right. Thank you.